Bring your bed liners, put your tailgates up, and get ready to make a NASCAR truck stop. Drivers from the Craftsman Truck Series conclude 3 days of testing at the big track by the beach, with Toyota Tundras getting a lot of attention in their Daytona debut. The reigning champ is here, so are a couple of former title winners returning after a few years of running elsewhere. We'll talk to those getting ready to race in a new place, a Dodge boy looking for redemption, and others ready to give the guys a run for their money. It's the truckers' turn to shine right now on Speed News. Countdown to Daytona. Everyone, I'm John Roberts, and this is Speed News Preseason Thunder Countdown to Daytona. Major change is on the way for this NASCAR season, and the Craftsman Truck Series is shaking things up as well. Now, not only is the opening race at Daytona under the lights live on Speed, but the series is full of new top-level drivers, and people from all over the racing world will be keeping an eye on Toyota's debut in NASCAR. But so far in testing, the Tundra has lagged, rarely breaking the top 20 on the Speed charts. Let's take a look at some testing from today, and we haven't heard this name in a while. Former Cup driver Steve Grissom topped all drivers as he's testing the number 59 Dodge, 182.9 miles an hour, maybe not as fast as you're used to seeing trucks go, but we will explain that in just a moment. Elsewhere in testing on the Speed chart, it was Terry Cook in the new Ford F-150 number 10 car, truck, I should say, as he goes around the track, also second on the cumulative Speed chart as well. Now, here's a guy to keep an eye on. Stedman Marlin is running fast, and he said his dad's going to have some work to keep up with him as he comes to test the Cup car tomorrow. And L.W. Miller is driving a number 28 truck this year as he advances series, turned a lap of 49.9, 180 miles per hour, and a couple of folks decided to load up and go away and not even take advantage of the afternoon session. But in the afternoon session, look at the Toyota hood on Mike Skinner's Toyota truck, as it looked like it was caving in a little bit, and we see some other guys running very well in their trucks in the afternoon. Jack Sprague, just a click under 50, the 75 truck of David Starr was also fast as well. And remember what happened to Ted Musgrave towards the end of last season, as he just barely missed that championship. He had a pretty good test session in that number one. Let's take a look at some of the cumulative speeds from preseason testing for the truck series. Steve Grissom topping everybody out, but as you take a look up and down the top 10 in speeds, look, there's a Dodge on top, then a couple of Fords. You got to go all the way down to the ninth spot to find your first Chevy truck, and to find the first Toyota, you'd have to go all the way down to the 18th spot, and that is David Ruderman in the number 17 Toyota. Well, again, this year, Speed Channel is the exclusive home for the Craftsman Truck Series. All races will be seen live. Now let's go to Bob Dillner, who has been trackside for the three-day Truck Series test. And Bob, has the word sandbagging come up yet when it comes to these Toyota Tundras?
A little bit of sandbagging talk, but of course this is Daytona testing. Now right now I would say Bobby Hamilton is probably the best amongst the Dodges, probably Matt Crafton in the Kevin Harvick truck with the Chevys, and then Carl Edwards in the Ford. Now as far as the Toyotas, they are all equal, but the problem is they are all off the pace.
We're behind a lot, but we kind of expect it to be. It's no big deal. We got a good group. Toyota seems to be awesome. I mean, they're just really working hard. Right now, the only right thing to do would be to chassis dyno all these trucks, the manufacturers, and try to get them a little more even.
We'll have to see where we end up and what happens when we come back for the race. You know how it is. So maybe the Toyotas will get a little help, or, you know, this or that. So we don't know what to exactly expect. This is also new, I'm really ready for the green flag.
Players from other teams think Toyota is making a political ploy for some help before returning to Daytona. In fact, some say Toyota's slow testing speeds are all a smokescreen.
How do you know they're not better? You know, I don't know. When Dodge came into this program, they did the same thing, and then they sent out a Paul Ruttman. So I'm not sure how good anybody is.
From what I understand, we're all supposed to have the same drag, and we're all supposed to kind of have the same horsepower. So I wonder why they're a second off the pace. I don't know. We'll see. I'm sure that they'll do their homework just like Ford has.
You know, they seem to be down a little bit in horsepower, but I don't think they'll be down for long. You know, it's a great program that they have, and you know, I think that they'll do their homework, and by the time we get a little further down the road in the season, they'll be strong.
I expected a lot more, but I'm sure that they have a little bit left in their back pocket. I mean, when we come back here in February, I'm sure that that's when, actually qualifying day is when we'll be able to tell what they've got. Up until that point, you don't know. I mean, Dodge a few years ago did the same thing and came and sat on the pole. I'm sure Toyota's not going to lay down for the next 3 weeks and say, this is what we've got. If they're legitimately struggling, they'll have it fixed when they come back.
Nearly all teams admit they are not showing their full hand at this test. In fact, the Ultra Boys brought two drivers plus two crew chiefs, but only one truck.
I give the morning session to Andy so I can sleep in, and then I take the afternoon session, so when it's nice and warm, when the sun comes up, then I get in. So, no, really, just swapping in and out. He feels the same thing I feel. You know, it's just like me being in the truck anyway, so I think it works really good. That way it gives the crew chiefs interactive participation, and the driver too. You know, what he tells me, I jump in and I can feel the same or relate back to him what we need to change. We're going to see a lot of that this year out of the team.
The trucks are going to be pretty close to the same, and basically we're just taking all our information. We both got the same chassis, bodies are going to be the same, so we're just taking information off one truck and we're going to apply it to both vehicles, and you know, we'll do a little more testing before we get down here, so you know, I think that we're doing the right thing.
Now, late in the day yesterday during the draft session, Chad Chaffin wrecked his number 18 Dickey's car. Actually, a truck, I should say. But today he was back in action in the boss man Bobby Hamilton's truck. And he did the morning session, then Bobby Hamilton hopped back in that number 4 truck in the afternoon. Now, get this. You were wondering why Bobby Hamilton Racing is so good here in Daytona. I was talking to Bobby yesterday, and he told me that he's already tested at Talladega 3 times. Add this, that makes it 4 tests, and he's still going back to Talladega next week for another 2-day test.
Well, Bob, this time last year, some of the Ford drivers were absolutely livid that Dodge had a distinct advantage, and as it turned out, Rick Crawford won the Daytona race in a Ford. Is there any kind of that politicking going on this year?
Well, remember, Rick Crawford was the guy last year that told me, hey, Bob, welcome to the Craftsman Dodge Truck Series. But really not much talk of that going on this year. And I think that's thanks to NASCAR's aero matching rules. They have made these trucks very, very equal. Although Toyota does look a little bit sluggish right now. A lot of people wondering, are they okay? Are they hiding something? The verdict is out on them right now, but they are going to Talladega next week as well for some more testing.
Hey, Bob, how huge is it to see all these former Cup drivers come down to this series? It's got to be a huge lift.
It is. You know, I talked to Steve Park yesterday, and we'll speak to him in just a short time on this show, but he's real excited about the Craftsman Truck Series. You see Bobby Hamilton over here. Mike Skinner is ready to go out on the attack, and, you know, Mike Skinner is really looking forward to this Daytona race. He really wants to win it, but right now just doesn't know if he can do that in the Toyota. I spoke to Wayne Auten, actually, just a short time ago. I said, Toyota's way behind. Are you going to give them anything coming into this race? He said, absolutely not right now, but you never know when we come back here in February.
All right, Bob, thanks a lot. We'll see you later with a special guest. Now, here's Toyota's lineup for 04. Former champ Mike Skinner, as well as defending champ Travis Quappel, will be Bang Racing teammates. Bill Lester and Shelby Howard will drive for Bill Davis Racing. Robert Huffman and Hank Parker Jr. are teammates at Innovative Motorsports. David Ruderman will drive for Darrell Waltrip, but old DW will drive some truck races himself. We're going to shift into reverse and look back at the first 2 days of Craftsman truck testing, including a wild ride for one of the Dodge boys. Then we'll turn to members of the Speed broadcast team for insight into the 2004 season. Well, the Florida Dodge Dealers 250 is the same for the trucks as the Daytona 500 is for the Nextel Cup drivers. So all weekend long, teams have been working to find speed and handling packages that can take them to victory lane in their biggest race of the season. The first truck on track Saturday was the 99 of Carl Edwards, the 3-time winner from last season. He and Roush teammate John Wood dominated opening day testing, but not quite enough for Carl to do a backflip after that one. Now, 3 Dodges also ran behind them. No one actually hit the wall, but Stan Boyd in a Ford right there had an engine meltdown, and that called for a bit of timeout for a cleanup. And if the pictures down there from Saturday look gray and cold, that's because it was. That's not what you expect to see people wearing in Florida in January. On to Sunday, when the temperatures were warmer. Of course, drafting practice is the key at a place like Daytona, but with close proximity comes contact. Watch Chad Chaffin get loose, get his Dodge down in the infield, and just when it looks like he had it under control, he gets up into the outside wall, and that's the wreck that Bob Dillner was talking about just a few minutes ago. Meanwhile, his boss, Bobby Hamilton, was quickest on Sunday, just off the time turned in by Carl Edwards. Well, three-wide photo finish decided the winner of last year's Florida Dodge Dealers 250. Rick Crawford won by 27 one-thousandths of a second. And Speed's Ray Dunlap and Phil Parsons were in the middle of it all. They tell us the competitive nature of this series isn't just a lot of hot air.
One of the reasons I think this weekend's three-day test session was so important for the Craftsman Truck Series is the fact that when we come back on race week, they'll have two less days of practice than we had last year. Now, a year ago when the trucks rolled in, to get the air to the engine, they actually used a ram air induction system where from the front of the grill, the air went up through a tube and into the air cleaner and carburetor. This year, it'll be completely different. For the first time ever, the air will go into the engines through a cold air box cowl induction system. Now, here is a cowl that we've removed from a truck. You can see the dimensions here are 2.5 by 20. That's the maximum hole you can have here, which lets a lot of air go to the engine. Now, the Craftsman trucks have never run a restrictor plate at Daytona. Sort of. Because this year, they will be reducing the airflow with this plate. Now, you'll see the dimension here is 1.25 by 6. And that lets a lot less air into the engine, reducing the horsepower. Now, when a NASCAR Nextel Cup car has a real restrictor plate under the carburetor, they lose almost 300 horsepower. For the trucks this year, it's only about a 50 horsepower reduction. But the one thing is, the trucks are a little bit slower this year because this brand new body style that they've put on has a lot more drag. And that keeps the speeds just right.
Ray, not only are the speeds just right, the competition is going to be just right this year, too. We have no fewer than 20 well-financed, well-funded, manufacturer-supported teams committed to running the entire schedule. We have returning champions Mike Skinner from 1995, three-time champion Jack Sprague returning to the Craftsman Truck Series. Steve Park also coming from the Nextel Cup Series, and we've already got Bobby Hamilton came last year and Ted Musgrave a couple years before that. And we've got Toyota, seven big-time teams, well-funded, well-supported, and in order to thwart off Toyota's challenge, the other three manufacturers are stepping up their involvement too. Ford, Dodge, and Chevrolet will increase their financial and engineering support to the Craftsman Truck Series. This will be by far the most competitive season we've ever seen in the 10-year history of the Craftsman Truck Series.
Well, Phil, the competition will certainly be different this year in the Craftsman Truck Series, and there will also be two brand new racetracks. Mansfield, Ohio comes on the schedule, which is a half mile, and for the first time ever, we'll be running at Atlanta Motor Speedway, which is the second race of the season. Now, all those 24 races after Daytona are completely different than this one. This is the biggest race of the year, and even though testing completes today at Daytona, the work is certainly not over.
Well, starting with the season opener under the lights at Daytona, Speed Channel is your exclusive home for the Craftsman Truck Series. Every race is live on Speed beginning February 13th at 8 o'clock Eastern. NASCAR veteran Steve Park is one of several drivers joining the tailgate brigade in 04. We'll talk to him and other fresh faces in the series coming up. Then we'll give you a taste of Preseason Thunder Fan Fest at Daytona, USA. Steve Park is a two-time winner in NASCAR's Nextel Cup Series, but a freak Busch Series accident at Darlington in 2001 sidetracked his career. This season, Park is behind the wheel of the 62 Orleans Dodge truck, and Steve is with Speed's Bob Dillner in Daytona. Bob?
That's right, John, and Steve is ready to go this season. You had a really good test here in the Craftsman Truck Series, but this kind of like a second chance for you.
Yeah, really it is. I mean, it's just I'm just glad to be in the Orleans Dodge, and with Dodge Motorsports behind us, the competition level in the Craftsman Truck Series is high, and a lot of times we talked about all the talent that's in there with Mike Skinner coming on board and stuff. it's going to make for an interesting year, and we're hoping that we can continue the tradition of putting that Orleans Chevrolet up front.
You know, I talked to Brendan Gaughan the other day, and he said, Steve came to us and he said, you know what, if you can give me exactly what he had last year, I want to be in that racetrack. Is that how it went down?
It really did. I mean, it was one of those things where I was kind of amazed that the seat opened up with Brendan moving on to the Penske Racing team, and I was like, ooh, I'm like, coach, put me in, man. I'm ready to go. And I was fortunate that Mr. Gaughan gave me the opportunity to come on board the Orleans team, and with Dodge Motorsports' help, really, it's exciting for me. It just gives me the opportunity to get back in equipment that can run good and win races again.
How quickly are we going to win races? I mean, you come here to Daytona in an awesome truck. We're going to win this race here?
Well, we're trying to. I mean, the effort that the Orleans team is putting in with the help from Dodge is second to none. We're going to leave here. We're going to test Talladega. I know you talked about Bobby Hamilton testing 3 or 4 times even before he came here. So, it's a big effort to come into Daytona and win the race. And it takes a consortium effort throughout the whole team to do that. So, it's one that we leave here, we test it here for 3 days, and now we're going to go test for 2 in Talladega and try to put that Orleans Dodge up front where it belongs.
You were dicing it up in the draft today, so how did it feel?
Actually, it felt pretty good. I mean, it felt pretty good in qualifying trim by itself, and we diced it up in the draft today, and the truck is good. I mean, it's, you know, we won't be satisfied until we're about a second faster than the competition, but right now the truck is decent. We need to be a little bit better, and we got a little work to do.
Can we see you in the Nextel Cup Series this year at all? I know you're working on something for the Bud Shootout.
Yeah, we're working on something for the Bud Shootout. We want to find a Dodge that's competitive week in and week out, and give us a shot at the Bud Shootout. So that's something we're going to work on now.
Well, we're certainly going to be watching you.
Oh, thanks, man.
Well, we're going to toss it back to John. You were practicing right before. You want to toss it back to him?
You got it. Back to you, John.
All right, good job, Steve. Steve Park and Bob Dillner. Guys, thanks a lot. And Steve, wish you all the best of luck this season. Now, starting tomorrow, the trucks give way to the even-numbered Nextel Cup points finishers from 2003. That list includes Jeff Gordon, Ryan Newman, and Bobby Labonte. We'll bring you coverage each night here on Speed. Join us Tuesday through Thursday live at 6 Eastern for Speed News Countdown to Daytona. Well, change is a fact of life in racing, but this year the Craftsman Truck Series is getting a real makeover. Three former champions are behind the wheels of new trucks, and of course, Toyota's arrival changes a lot. But let's hear from some other drivers with new rides.
Well, I mean, it's always exciting when you can move up a step in NASCAR, and the horsepower is different, the wheelbase, the weight of the truck, so it's a lot to get used to.
I'm so used to going race to race and not knowing if you're going to have a deal or if there's ever going to be a deal, and then come over here and run my first laps with Daytona. I've been coming over here my whole life, and to be on this side of the fence is a whole lot better than being over there.
Man, this is going to be fun. This is going to be an awesome season here in the trucks, and got a lot of great guys. We're going to have some fun racing. It's going to be really competitive and exciting, and I'm just glad to be a part of it.
I got to be involved with the Goody's Dash Series with the Toyota Celica and the V6 program there, and fortunate enough, they're looking after me and bringing me into this program, and hopefully get to see it develop into what the Dash program did.
You know, I ran ARCA the last 2 years, and definitely learned a lot there, and this is just going to be another step to what I hope to accomplish someday.
I'm just trying to get to the next level, whether it's been IRL from where I came from, kart series, or NASCAR, and NASCAR seemed to be the opportunities that I had, and I got some help last year from Dodge, and now I've landed this right on the course.
A lot of good names are coming in, and I really like trucks better than I did bush cars when I run them, and I got with a good team, like I said, and things are looking real good for a season.
I don't know. Am I a rookie? They haven't said yet, so we're going for it. We're going to see if they'll approve me to run for Rookie of the Year. I mean, I think we can have a real good shot at it. If I don't get to run, I don't want to put that yellow stripe across my bumper. I do know that.
NASCAR Preseason Thunder continues through the weekend. Join us live Sunday at 6 for the latest news from Busch Series testing, followed by Speed News Sunday at its regular time, 7 p.m. Eastern. Great seats are still available for all Speed Week's events at Daytona, including the Florida Dodge Dealers 250 and the Great American Race itself. Log on to Daytona500.com or call 1-800-PIT-SHOP. Don't get stuck on the street with a sign that reads, "Need tickets." As part of Daytona's preseason thunder, fans got an opportunity to talk with the new and familiar faces of the Truck Series over the weekend. As Bob Dillner found out at Daytona USA, the event turned into a real talent show.
Fans were excited to see their favorite drivers at this edition of the 2004 NASCAR Thunder Fan Fest. Not only did they get a chance to ask drivers questions, but they were also treated to a night of tricks and flips.
I think that was a challenge that you issued to him.
I've worked real hard on this move, okay? So just bear with me, get the cameras ready.
Okay.
Someone asked me just this week what was my most memorable moment this past year in the NASCAR Craftsman Truck Series. And actually, it was here last year at Daytona after the race. Richard Petty came walking in my trailer and put his arm around me and patted me on the back and told me what a great job I'd done. And that was just very, very exciting for me.
This year, the race is going to be at night. And I said last year after I won the thing, I was going to party all night long. So you'll see four wide racing all night long, I guarantee you that. I said it was a plus for NASCAR Craftsman Truck Series to be run at night, and that way it'd give the fans the full effect. I mean, everybody wants to see smoke, fire, sparks. They got to put it under the lights in order to see that, so we'll have a good time down here.
Well, be sure to tune to Speed Channel February 16th for the network's reality show NBS 24/7. The program will feature NASCAR Busch Series drivers Casey Atwood, Casey Kane, Tim Fedewa, and Randy LaJoy. No scripts, no casting, and no kissing reptiles. Just whatever happens at the track, even before the green and after the checkers. NBS 24/7 is set to debut with back-to-back episodes February 16th at 8 o'clock. Thanks for joining us for Speed News Countdown to Daytona Tuesday. The even-numbered Nextel Cup cars take to the tracks to start getting ready for the 500, so we'll see you here tomorrow night.
For motorsports coverage 24/7, log on to speedtv.com.